you, everyone. Good afternoon. First of all, I would like to convey our chairman's message to everyone here, an opportunity that he could not attend this important session due to his commitment in an important session with the all of the influence group in the energy sector as part of a key step for the energy reform. They're going to discuss on and clear on the certain pending issue that it would be beneficial for the conclusion of the agreement in the future energy reform for Thailand. But anyway, my name is Suphatthana Phong Phanmi Chao, Senior Executive Vice President of Corporate Strategy for PTT. I will try my best to carry the message of our chairman in relation to the new strategy, short term, medium term, and the long term for PTT. I will go by a few slides, and then after that, if you have any question or any Q&A, feel free to ask, and I will share my input as much as I can. Slide, please. Yep, prospect for PET Group under the new leadership. We just have the so-called strategic thinking session among the management of PTT, as well as the board of directors. This is an event that happens every year that we have to review the strategy, as well as commitment or recommendation from the board. As you may aware that we have several number of the new director to the PTT board, and we also have the new chairman as well. The conclusion for such strategic thinking session is that in the short term, we're going to enhance our business transparency in order to make our Thai people to understand how PET performing our business, as well as fair competition, and including the turnaround of the certain unit that we still underperform, as well as also on the portfolio management, which I will share with you in the subsequent session. And in the medium term, we're going to embed that so-called TACNOC. We have spent 3 years in consecutive in implementing a strategic group initiative so-called TACNOC, Technological Advanced Green National Oil Company. Basically, we're going to strengthen or having technology and green become one a key strategic initiative for PTT group sustainability. And in the long term, but we have to discuss this year, since we have used vision, PTT group vision, so-called Thailand Multi-Energy Company for I think 8 years, and it's about the time that we have to revisit our vision for 2028, which is the year that PTT will become having 50th anniversary. We call it Reimagine PTT 50. Next page. Before I go to the detail, I would like to recap a bit for everyone, for anyone who didn't know much about PTT. Quick one. We are the a full long value chain. Okay, we have natural gas business, oil business, international business within the PTT group, PTT company, public company, whereby we have investment through our group company, ENP, as you know. I think they are very strong, and they have the private session today as well. Downstream business, we have five refinery, petrochemical, and led by PTGC, and then several other petrochemical company. We have a newly formed company as a group member, is the GPSC, is the power flagship company of PTT Group, having PTT 30%. International investment business actually led by our PTEP, formerly called PTT International. They will focus on the coal mining business. And we also have PTT Green Energy, who invest in the palm plantation in Indonesia. And look at the performance of PTT over the past several years, 10 years after listing. Is the in terms of revenue is growing constantly. And if you look at the ranking in the Fortune 500, we keep improving. The most currently we have number 84. No, we used to be 81. We reduced a little bit. But in terms of profit, that is up and down, and it's remained approximately 80 to 100 for several years, at least 5 years. And I think the two hanging matter that causing PTT profit or net income is not as good as, or is not grow as revenue, is because, I think next slide, basically the LPG and NGV. Let me recap a bit as well. PTV still has a government cap the LPG price at the X gas separation plant at the $333 a ton, whereby the overall cost, not including profit, of PTT conducted by Deloitte study is keep increasing from 450, now 575. In the past, 333 still cover the certain feed costs, but now since after 2012, it's no longer cover the feed cost, not even cover the fixed cost. That caused a big burden to our gas separation plant operation. The number that we cumulative altogether is 27 billion since 2010, 2012. And to prove to everyone that the LPG price here in Thailand is still much, much lower than the neighboring country. You can see our price still 22 baht per kilogram, but for the poor, for the low income sector, we still offer an even deeper subsidized at the 18 baht per kilo. Basically, we are the lowest within this region. Next is on the, this is the oil fund, okay? PTT, we subsidize at the price of the X refinery, X the gas separation price at 333, but still not enough. At this retail LPG price, as I mentioned, the government have to subsidize as well through the oil fund. Because the number of the LPG demand has been increasing as well due to the very, very low price under the subsidy. We have to import LPG at the market price. In such case, the government have to subsidize on this portion so that the amount of the subsidy under the oil fund increasing as well. Currently it's 35 billion baht or billion to US dollar today. This is the issue of the LPG subsidy in Thailand. But this on oil fund is on the government side. But on the next is on the NGV. NGV is purely on PTT side. We have to, under the government policy, the price has been capped at 10.5 baht, whereby the cost is more than that. The cumulative of the NGV subsidy that PTT have to absorb over the past more than 10 years is 100 billion baht. It's almost 3.5 billion US dollar cumulative. Those are the two issues that overhang and is affecting the net income of PTT growth and is affecting the share price in the secondary market of PTT as well. Next. But PTT Group still being the largest market cap company in stock Thailand stock market. We account for 15% at this moment. At the highest, we used to be 25. Because of, as I said, the profits is not increasing, or the growth is not increasing as, you know, in accordance with the revenue we have annually. And the shareholding structure remains the same. The government still the highest, telling the highest percentage holding in PTT, whereby we still have Thai public 16%, foreign 17%, and social security. And altogether, it still belongs to basically the government more than almost 70%. In terms of contribution to the country, say since after listing or after privatization, we have already contributed a trillion baht to the government by way of dividend, by way of tax. Pre-privatization, still only something billion baht. But post-privatization contribution by way of dividend and tax from PTT to government is almost 45 billion baht or more than 1.5 billion US dollar. This is a short-term issue. And the strategy that the board has reached with the management of PTT in relation to the strategic thinking session. One of the initiatives that we like to make sure that Thai people will understand that. We will make ourselves more transparent. We will spin off our natural gas transmission pipeline. Actually, the National Energy Policy Council on 15th of August recently has passed a resolution to allow PTT to spin off natural gas transmission business and set up a wholly owned company to run its pipeline. The pipeline will belong to the new company, whereby the O&M, the operation, will belong to the PTT gas operation. This is to prove to the government that we have honored what we have committed since as a precondition before the privatization. And it's been postponed due to the previous government. And having this company only own the pipeline, it will prove to the public as well that how much the tariff, how much we earn from the pipeline. It's not 100 billion profit. It's not 100 billion profit at their well. They have still have a misunderstanding that, you know, PTT make a lot of money or make a lot of profit from the pipeline operation. This is one of the initiatives on the short term that we have to make ourselves more transparent. Next. And we're gonna enter a portfolio management. And it's part of the business transparency as well. Some group of people has accused P PTT being monopoly in the refinery sector. We are a member, we are a shareholder, five out of six refinery in Thailand. So the board also decided to divest our PTT portion in our holding in Bang Chak, BCP. We hold 27%, as well as 31% in SPRC through the IPO process. This has been approved. Next. And we also look at the, in terms of portfolio as well, focus on the new core business, rationalized non-core business. It doesn't mean that we have to keep everything, you know. In the past, you know, for PTT, we always keep everything. We don't want to divest it. We proved already that we're going to divest BCP as well as SPRC. Now we're going to divest palm oil plantation. We learn, we try our best throughout the past several years. And it's proved to be that it's not in line with our strategy, as well as it's not fit with our strength and our excellence. So we decide to divest it. And we have to fix certain problems in the international investment on the EMG pipeline. As you may aware that we have 25% investment in the East Mediterranean gas pipeline in Egypt to supply the gas from Egypt to Israel due to the conflict within Egypt as well as within Israel. There's a certain interruption on the gas pipeline from Egypt. So the pipeline is still idle, but still there. Okay. We have to find a way to divest it. In parallel, we also preserve our right to take certain legal action against the Egypt gas supply company, basically a national oil gas company of Egypt, to preserve our life, preserve our investment. So we do certain legal action. Hopefully, the ruling of such legal action will come out soon, maybe end of this year, beginning of next year. It's, you know, the legal action is time-consuming process. And in terms of new core business, I mentioned a little bit on the GPSC, our global power synergy company. It's our power generation company. We're going to have the, we separate the company, consolidate all the power generation asset among within the group. And then we have a plan to divest it through the IPO as well. And also in the core business, it become clearer. It used, the COVID business used to be under the PTT International. And International is doing a lot of things. But we make it clearer by reduce the scope of PTT International and convert it into the core business only. We rename it as well. We name it PTT ER, PTT Energy Resources. And we still have a target with a prudent consideration as well that we want to be one of the leading coal mining company in this region with a target of 38 million tons in 2025. Next. Now, is the on the medium and the long term. It may be a little bit on the soft side, but I would like to recap a bit as well. Since the 1978, we are still, you know, at the early stage. We focus on local investment, for energy security, build a pipeline, dealing with the local E&P, build a petrochemical here in Thailand to create the long value chain, building our oil and gas network, petrol station, basically in Thailand. And then we gradually increase or create growth within Thailand organically. And then when the 1997, when there is the debt crisis, economic crisis in Thailand, we do listing after that. We have some proceeds. We utilize our proceeds from the listing wisely. We do acquire, instead of organic growth, we do inorganic growth by acquiring any problem or any problem asset in Thailand. And we have another growth through the inorganic via the proceeds that we got from the IPO. And then the future, we're going to transform ourselves into the knowledge-based organization. Become more international, being technology-oriented and green-oriented as well. So-called techno, bring embed technology and green into a national oil company role as formerly be as PTT, which is will be coined and aligned with the country direction. Yeah, this is the little bit elaboration of the our definition of TACNOC. As I said, we have implemented 3 years consecutively, and this year we're going to embed it into the whole process of the way we develop the strategic initiative throughout the group. We're going to talking about the green target, the technology target. And also, we still keep our national oil in terms of energy security, national wealth, and to support Thailand into knowledge-based economy as being the role of NOC. And in the long, long term for the reimagining PTT in the 50-year anniversary of PTT, we're going to have the new vision, as I mentioned to you at the beginning. We used to have vision of PTT being Thailand premier multinational energy company. It's going to change. There are 3-4 possibilities. But I cannot disclose for you now EA, SI mean, or CatNEC mean, or GOS mean. I keep it secret for a while. And next year, I'm going to disclose it. What does it mean? Or which one we're going to pick it up as being the new vision for PTT in 2028. And eventually, we will be the knowledge-based organization. This is the assembly of what will happen and what is the strategic direction that we have reached with the new management of new board member of the PTT group. Thank you. If you have any question, feel free to answer it.
Thank you very much. And now we open the floor for a Q&A session. Please raise your hand or, again, write it on a paper and pass it on to the crews or the officers here. Okay, so while waiting, I also have some few questions from the notes from the audience here.
Yep, please.
Okay. The first question, what will be the key policy changes for PTT going forward?
I think we have a long-term aspiration already. Everyone knows this is for up to 2020. PTT group member, we have aspiration. Everyone knows already we have the 3 target Dow Jones, Fortune 100, DJSI member, and ROIC become in the first quartile. Problem is that, and we have looked at it, in the past several years, we found that our return on, I think everyone knows it, yeah, return on capital investment or invested capital, it become lower. In the short term, 3-4 years, we must turn around. the board and has assigned our chief operating officer, both upstream and downstream, to in charge on the turnaround of the return of the invested capital. And going forward, definitely appear in the aspiration of each group member already. For PTEP, they have 300,000 barrels. They have to do the at least ROIC average, and they have to have RP ratio. That is remain the same, but promise now we still not yet achieve it. So we have to moving forward and to get that. That is still a very clear direction that we have to achieve. Petrochemical as well.
Okay, and the next question. How do you think OPTT is able to improve your future investment?
Sorry?
How will PTT improve your future investments?
As I said, we have a portfolio management. I have explained to you already, you know, that, you know, anything doesn't make profit. Anything that we are not good at it, you're gonna divest it without delay, okay? Anything that may cause confusion or cause any misunderstanding or cause any our business model, we're gonna divest it without delay, okay? Anything that non-perform or underperform, we're gonna fix it if it is under our strategy.
And now from the floor, has anyone has any question? Please raise your hand.
When can we expect the subsidies to be removed?
Thank you. That's why our chairman spent most of the time, you know, today, okay? It could, we believe, okay, it would be, you know, and we have already done some, you know, homework and as well as some explanation to the so-called KSOCHO, okay? That the subsidy actually it may be a good thing in short term, but in the long term, it will be, it will hinder the economic growth of the country. We believe that this issue will be discussed under the Energy Reform Council that they're gonna pick up all the they call it the Reform Council, the National Council, the National Reform Council. Mm-hmm. This will be part of it, definitely. And it become, and we luckily, most of the country in this region, i.e. Indonesia, Malaysia, and even in Middle East, they are going to lift all the subsidy out. Indonesia is clear. Egypt is clear. In Egypt, they increased the petroleum fuel by 60%. They increased the gas price 60% as well, because there's no E&P activity in Egypt at all, even though they have abundance of the gas resources in Egypt. But the gas price is very low, so that nobody can invest on it. Those examples, those issues, those impact, we have write it up, we have conveyed it to the KSOCHO already, and we do believe that they will understand it, and they will take it seriously as part of the agenda in the energy reform matter.
Okay, any other questions? And I have a few questions here also. How will PTT encourage transparency and fair competition?
As I mentioned into the short-term plan as well, you know, we have them and people accuse us, we have 5 out of 6 refinery investment, you know, we said, okay, we don't mind, we're gonna divest BCP, we're gonna divest SPRC, we keep only 3, And two out of three is not a refinery. Two out of three is the petrochemical. Actually, we only having Thai oil as being a real refinery.
And also, what does PTT think the energy reform should be?
It should be actually the theme of the energy reform has been set by the Khosrochaw already. It will be transparency, it has to be fair, and it has to be sustainable. This is the outline or the basis for the new energy reform for Thailand. And I have already added that it has to be under the free market platform as well. So I hope that they will recognize it and they will take it into account as part of the new Thai energy reform. Thank you.
Okay, and this question is about PTT's pipeline separation. Will it be privatized?
We still not yet discussed on this matter, but the MOF would like to have the government or the Ministry of Energy would like to have participation of the government into this company. That is the government policy.
And this question focuses on international business. How will PTT capture growth in Southeast Asia?
Oh, definitely. Put it this way. As part of our TACNOC initiation, we have AEC initiative as well. We have finished or finalized or conclude our AEC version 3 already. We identify the target in each country, in this region. We identify who will be the host, who will be the key player in each country, okay? And you will see a lot of PTT group member participation in various invitation or bidding for investment or joint venture opportunity in ASEAN country soon.
Okay, any other questions from the floor? Please. Okay, if no more question, thank you very much, Mr. Supattanapong Phanmeechau, Senior Executive Vice President of Corporate Strategy, PTT Public Company Limited. Ladies and gentlemen, please give big hands to the gentleman.